each other's problem. The God might have relieved some of his burdens. I am Ankur Kapoor, and I want to start my presentation with a story. The story, Mike got an assignment. Mike is a person who lives in California, a student about 14 or 15 years old. You know, studying in a very good school, lives in a house which is full of prosperity. He does not know anything about poverty, anything about hunger. The question of his assignment is, why some people are poor and hungry? Mike, as I told you, does not know anything about it, goes to his father and asks the same question, that why people are hungry? Are they too lazy to earn their own food? Father says, no, it's not like that. Well, actually, their opportunities are less and they have low income. Okay, so when the Mike heard these two words, low opportunities and low income, the word that comes to his mind instantly, the word that he has heard in 2-3 years so many times, he says to his father, oh dad, is there recession? So the father laughs and says, no, it's not recession. Actually, the problem is with the growth. And you would have to understand some basic economics about growth and development to understand why they are poor. Economic growth. Well, economic growth means there is an increase in output per head of population, per capita. And besides that, there has to be a sustained increase. You know, the rising or upward moving trend over a long period of time in per capita. We as America, we as UK had it, always have it, that's why we are rich. They never had it, they cannot have it, that's why they are poor. I will show you some of the graphs. US, USA, 14 million, or 14 trillion, I'm sorry, GDP, per capita $47,000. Ethiopia, not even like, just 1,000. Afghanistan, not even $1,000 per capita income. Again, growth is more than development. Well, you have to understand that growth means just increase in output. Where development means there is increase in output as well as there has to be a substantial change in the technology, in the way we produce, in institutional arrangements. So, now, well, I would like to, you know, explain you with the help of this simple equation, the GDP equation or the growth equation. Growth is a function of three factors, mainly, which are labor, number of labor input, L. K is the stock of, L is the number of labor, K is the number of the capital stock, and N is the natural resource. In any country which are developing, even as India, we have all three factors, we are using them, we are developing them. Do you think that or, you know, capital is available in America or Africa? Natural resources, 17 countries in Africa are landlocked. They do not have an ocean and they are not so rich that they build, that they can build airports in every second city so that they can have international trade. They cannot. So, no capital, no natural resources, no change, no development. Well, Mike has this, another question. So ask your father, okay, they do not have capital, they do not have labor, they do not have natural resources, why didn't they work for some other person? Get a job, earn for yourself, why you want help? So his father says, okay, their unemployment is not based on the Keynes model of unemployment, which means there is, cyclical unemployment, it comes and goes with the business cycle, recession, boom. Their unemployment is based on the Mexican model of unemployment, which means that they have a reserved number of unemployed labor force. What is it? Okay. Suppose if A is the number of people who are employed, they are available as labor, and N is the number of people who are employed at current capital level, the number of the capital available in the market. So A minus N would be the people who are the reserved army of unemployed forces. They cannot be employed. So what is the problem? What is the problem that I actually have told you? The problem is capital production. Capital, if given to them, would do, you know, wonders for them. Wonders. And Amartya Sen is in his book, Freedom for Development, has also said that the people have to build their own capabilities to be developed. They have hunger, they have under nutrition, they have unemployment, all would be, you know, given given time, given capital, would be eradicated. So, capital crunch, and if global it exists, the capital crunch disappears. Now, next I would like to tell you, you know, besides that, besides this capital crunch, I would like to draw your attention on the fact that people in these countries are unemployable. In India, I, after passing out MBA, would be called unemployed graduate. The people who have never gone to school, not know anything about education, how can that person be employable? How can that person be, you know, bring some kind of development in his own country? They are dependent. So, if introduced, would lead to capital, would lead to trade, would lead to employment, and would lead to development, for sure. And development definitely is in the core. You would have to remove first health problems, unemployment problems, capital problems, education problems, all the problems, and only then you can actually drag out development. And aid with the help of internal policy can actually do wonders and can do development. Thank you. Well, this is something I would like to tell you that my opponent Putin has, taken the name of America almost like 15 times in his presentation. So, this is a graph. This is a graph of the people, the countries who are actually providing aid, almost all of them. New Zealand, they provide around like less than, as it is stated, like less than 1 million. And we have USA, who is providing more than 25 billion. So it means, what this brings to your mind? It means that USA is giving more aid to take over the market, to take over all the world. Just waiting. Because I would like to draw in terms of GNI, the percentage of the percentage of their economy they are contributing to global aid. It's not USA who is giving just 0.16% of their GNI. It's actually Luxembourg or Norway who are trying to steal away Africa. It's not USA. I think according to your point of view, it's Norway or Luxembourg who want to buy the whole of Africa and try to, build their own Luxembourg there. Well, I'm just almost completing with the fact that Joshua's chimera. Well, this is the picture of Joshua. Joshua is a boy who has been, orphaned in Haiti earthquake, and this is his uncle. This fact is that the photograph shows here that his uncle is dropping him to an orphanage center. Okay, so what is the chimera Joshua has? Joshua has a chimera that he would die out of hunger. He would die, as other people died out of hunger, either or on the road of Haiti. Because nobody is there to take care of him. But it's not like that. Because his father is dropping him to an orphanage, a shelter made by the US aid, and he has a future. He has education lying in front of him, he has food lying in front of him, and most of that, and better than that, he has hope lying in front of him. Next, I would like to end my part with a simple saying of Mother Teresa. It's not how much love, it's not how much we do, this love that we put in doing. It's not how much we give, it's actually the love that we put in giving. I would like to call now Shubhangi to continue with the flow of presentation, and I would like to tell you that how global aid generates and how people try to help.
You can have a continuous, a programme, stick out